In this question, you are required to match each numbered region in the plastic model with a lettered endoscopic image. So in the plastic model, the first site is located at the gastroesophageal junction, the cardiac orifice of the stomach. If we study the endoscopic views, we will look at the first endoscopic view here, A. Let's try to describe the features. There is a smooth mucosal lining in here. Then, more distally, there is like a narrowing in the center with some longitudinal folds are seen, creating a rosette shape. In addition to that, there is a line in here, an irregular line as well. These conform to the features of the gastroesophageal junction. The esophagus is lined by stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, and it doesn't have any folds in the mucosa. At the junction with the stomach, there is usually a distinct circular zigzag line, which makes the border between the esophageal mucosa and the gastric mucosa. The esophageal mucosa is stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, and the gastric mucosa is a simple columnar epithelium. And this junctional zone, which is zigzag, circular, is known to anatomists as the ora serrata, and to clinicians, it's mostly referred to as the Z-line. So the Z-line, you can see the Z-line here, very clear. This junction is either located at or about 1 or 2 centimeters above the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm, and it's the line of demarcation between two types of mucosa. As I mentioned, it can be seen when there is no pathology. So all the features here are the features of the gastroesophageal junction, and so one matches with A. Two indicates the body of the stomach, and if we look at B, we will find that it also conforms with the body of the stomach, because here we can see that there is a mucosa which has longitudinal folds. These are the rugae of the stomach, the longitudinal folds, the rugae of the stomach that increase the surface area and allow for the distension of the stomach. This is a very characteristic feature of the stomach. So two matches with B. Now, three is located just distal to the pyloric sphincter. So it is in the beginning of the first part of the duodenum. That's to say the region of the duodenal cap, as known to radiologists. The first inch of the first part of the duodenum. Now let's look at C in here. This is a view of the inside of the larynx. As you can see here, these are the vocal folds. You can see through the opening between the vocal cords, the rima glottidis, you can see the trachea. So in fact, this is not an endoscope, it is a bronchoscope, and this shows the upper part of the larynx above the vocal folds. These are the arytenoid cartilages, and this is the root of the epiglottis. So it doesn't match with the first part of the duodenum. If you look at D, you will find that there is a tube with a very large lumen. There are haustrations. The tube has an almost triangular outline with three angles here. And also you can see that the patient here is not that well prepared. You can see some of the feces are located in here. Actually, even if the feces were not located, the other features of the tube are the features of the large intestine, and to be specific, it is the transverse colon. So large lumen, haustrations, and a triangular outline. Because of the presence of these three strips of teeny coli, this is a characteristic feature of the transverse colon. Now, if you look at E, you will find that there is part in here which is smooth. The mucosa is smooth. But the distal part, you can see that there are transverse or circular folds. These circular folds are the plicae circularis, the characteristic feature of the small intestine. And we can say that this is the duodenum. to be specific, this is the first part of the duodenum, because the remaining part of the duodenum contains the plicae circularis. It doesn't have a smooth part. The smooth part of the duodenum is located at the duodenal bulb, and that's why it appears smooth in an x-ray, in a barium follow-through. It appears smooth because it doesn't have these mucosal folds. So this endoscopic view is showing part of the tube that is smooth and part of the tube that has circular folds, and this is characteristic of the first part of the duodenum, and therefore 3 matches E.